Welcome to 1-2-League Online Sunday Service, everybody! By the way, I'm Teacher Gigi. And since some people are watching from all over the world, I just want to say hi, hello, bonjour, hola, kumusta, como esta to everyone! Alright, just a quick recap. Last Sunday, we learned from Pastor Rean about the most popular book in the whole wide world. And that is the... Yes, the Holy Bible. The Bible is composed of letters, stories, and poems, which are called scriptures, which all lead to and point to Jesus. And what blew my mind is that before the Bible was ever written in pages or paper, people in the old days used to speak about these stories by memory. Amazing, right? And to share with us his own takeaways from last Sunday's lesson, please welcome Kobe Makabebe.
Hi kids, I am Kobe and this is my takeaway from last Sunday's message. This is my first Bible. As it is the Word of God, it is also His love letters to us. It is like a manual of instructions on how we deal with life. So kids, always read your Bible so you get to know who God really is and what He wants us to do. Bye kids! Have a blessed Sunday!
And now, let's proceed to our announcements. Do you guys visit our Wonder League page during the weekdays? If you don't, I highly encourage you to do so. Here are the answers to our weekly activity sheets. Let's take a look! Wow! Amazing, right? Wait, there is more. For your information, we have Zoom Hangouts called the Heroes Assembly later this afternoon at 4 p.m. Also, flashing your screens is the squad dinner from last week. If you want to join later and don't have a squad yet, don't worry because we will assign you to your own squad, okay? So go ahead and set your alarm clocks now and wait for further announcements in the coming days. And now, are you ready for a praise and worship? Let us all stand up and be in our prayer position. Let us all together pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this wonderful day. We thank you for your presence, which goes with us wherever we go. Father, we open our hearts to receive whatever you have in store for us today. We give you the highest praises, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Cannot move, the fortress I run to. You're holding me close, making me strong within. You give me hope that never fails. It lights up the darkness, surrounding my heart, surrounding my soul again. Troubles on the way, you come to my rescue and run to my side the moment I call your name. I will be bold and stand my ground because you are with me. No, you won't see me running. My victory is coming. enemy is greater than the one inside of me. No fire, no fire, no fire, no fire, no fire from the enemy is greater than the one inside of me. No fire, no fire, no fire, no fire, no fire from the enemy is greater than the one inside of me. No fire, no fire, no fire, no fire, no fire from the enemy is greater than the one inside of me. No fire, no fire, no fire, no fire.
Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
The books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. The books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me.
The books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
The books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. The books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. Of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. Books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, and now it's 1st Timothy, then it's 2nd Timothy, Titus and Philemon, and Hebrews. was James. Now it's First Peter, and then it's Second Peter. First John, Second John, Third John, Jude.
Revelation.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free. A gift for you, for me. Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians. Now it's 1st Timothy, then it's 2nd Timothy, Titus and Philemon, Hebrews, James. Now it's 1st Peter, and then it's 2nd Peter, 1st John, 2nd John, 3rd John, Jude. Books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free. A gift for you, for me. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
Now you know the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. Yeah, you know the books of the Bible, the wonderful books.
It's a letter. A gift for you, for me. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
Oh, hey, what's up, Wonder League? It's me, Teacher Jay. Do you remember this? Yes, this is a Bible. Last time, we learned from Pastor Ryan that the Bible or the scripture is the word of God. It is also His love letter given to us specifically. It is full of stories of people, places, and events on how it is focusing on God and how He has displayed who He is and His character. The Bible also shows how powerful and merciful, faithful, kind, generous, loving, and caring God is to us. You know, the Bible was written for us or for His people, just like you and me, that's you and me, to discover more of who He is. Okay, today we will continue to talk about the Bible. B-I-B-L-E. Specifically, the usefulness of it in our daily lives. You know, Wonder League, when you walk into any bookstore and you will find a number of books that are very interesting and very convincing to buy, like your favorite fairy tales, comic books, manga books, and many other trending or best-selling books. But kids, there are two questions that you must ask about such books. First, is it reliable? Can I trust what the author is saying? Second, is it useful or helpful for me? So, if that book doesn't help me, I won't buy it. I need a book that speaks to where I'm at. If you can show me a book that is proven to be reliable and useful, I'll buy it and read it. Maybe. But this book has been proven to be totally reliable. No one has ever been disappointed. And the book is useful to every human being. That is you and me, right where they are at. And yet, strangely, it sits abandoned on our shelves while we are so busy on our gadgets, playing ML, and watching TikTok, or watching television all day. Oh my. What I'm talking about is, of course, the Bible. It is a book that is totally reliable and useful for every person. In every country around the globe, no matter what your situation in life, it has never let anybody down. You know, kids, the Bible is not a good luck charm. Having a copy in a noticeable place in the house will not help your family. Like any book, the Bible will help you only if you read it, study it, and apply it to your life. I want to convince you that you need the Bible because it is totally reliable and useful for all of life. I want you kids to be convinced of it so that you will meditate upon it and apply it on a regular basis. God wants us to be closer to Him because He is dependable and wants to do life together with us. He wants you and me to read His love letter and get to know who He is and who we are in Him. Now, kids, there are two important things why we need to use the Bible. We use the Bible because it is totally reliable. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 to 17, it says there, all scripture is God-breathed, and it's useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. You know what? All scripture is God-breathed. That is the best translation. This means that God is the originator of scripture. Since it comes from God, who is reliable, all scripture is reliable. That is why we can give our 100% trust and hope to God's instructions and promises into our lives. Second, we use the Bible because it is useful for all of life. This is our life manual. Can you say that with me? Life manual. You know, kids, actually the Bible has an acronym. B-I-B-L-E. It means Best Instructions Book for Living Every Day. Wow, amazing, right? Imagine God going through all the troubles in saving us and then saying, you're on your own, look to the world, and maybe you'll figure out how to get through life. There is no problem in life for which the Bible does not provide God's wisdom. either through a clear teaching or through principles that applies. But in verse 16, Apostle Paul shows us how the scripture is useful. Everybody say useful. And in verse 17, he shows the result of such usefulness. Now, how is scripture useful? Useful for teaching God's truth, useful for confronting our sin, and useful for correction, and also useful for training for righteousness. See, kids, no matter where you're at, or where you're from, or whatever your situations, the scriptures are useful in your life. The final result when we use the Bible is when we might live a happy life and a selfless life, and also develop an intimate relationship with God. That is the purpose why we need to use the Bible. All right? So, well, that's all for now, kids. I hope and pray that God will give you a hunger and thirst for His Word and continue to get to know Him deeper. Bye and see you next time.
Hello, Wonder League! How are you guys doing? Well, I hope and pray that you and your families and loved ones are safe, well, and healthy. So last week, you learned about what the Bible is. Now you know what it is. Now, the Bible has a lot of stories such as... Let me see if you know this. This boy who defeated a giant with a sling. Do you know who he is? Correct, David. And how about this one? Someone who used his rod to separate the seas and lead the people of Israel. All right, correct. It's Moses. You see, the Bible has a lot of exciting stories. Not just exciting, but stories that are full of wisdom, hope, and faithfulness of God. Now, I just want to connect this with what Teacher Jay has said and shared earlier. That the Bible is not just a book. The Bible is a manual. What is a manual? It is an instructional book that can help us with our daily life. We can depend on this book. Yes, the Holy Bible. You know, before I met Jesus, and before he found me, I didn't know about this book. But when he found me, my good friend back in the day was the first one who gave me a Bible. And in it was written a Bible scripture. And when I read it, it was so powerful that it turned my life 180 degrees. Without this Bible, I wouldn't be where I am now. I wouldn't be who I am now. That's why I'm thankful and grateful to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So, this is my prayer and declaration for you. So, prayer position! Abba Father, thank you for your loving word. We know that we can always depend on it in our everyday life. Thank you that we have the best instruction book for living every day, the Bible. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody says, Amen. Bye, Wonder League.
Wow, that was amazing, Captain Prayer. Also, thank you so much, Teacher Jay, for the amazing Bible lesson. What I got from today's lesson is that reading the Bible does not only point us to Jesus, it also helps us, guides us, empowers us, and encourages us in our everyday actions and decisions. Imagine buying a toy or a gadget from a store. When you open the package, you'll see perhaps a small booklet or a notebook, which is called the manual. The manual tells you how the thing you bought functions, how to troubleshoot or repair once you encounter any problem, and how you can maximize the use of that thing. The Bible is like that, a manual, but we apply it in our lives. The scriptures in the Bible tell us, or help us rather, in everyday life to do the right thing. We'd also love to hear your takeaways too. Just comment down below what you learned from today's lesson. Come on, type it down, and we would love to read them all. To help us with our power verse, please welcome Aaron Alipio.
Hello everyone! I am Jeremy Aaron. Today I will share to you our power verse. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Joshua 1 verse 8. See ya!
Alright, that's all we have for today's Wonder Geek. Just always tune in and watch us online. Don't forget to like and share our Wonder Geek page. Just keep praying, eat your balanced meals, take your vitamins, wash your hands more often, and help your parents in doing household chores. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone. Don't forget, Jesus loves you. See you again next week. Bye!